clouds now coming up to the coastal plain here as the center of circulation continues to move its way slowly towards the north. Again, this storm has been mainly a right-handed storm with a lot of action to the right of the center of circulation. And with the flow coming up from the east and southeast, you can see that southeastern North Carolina will feel the brunt of this one. Here's a look at the Doppler radar from the entire region of North and South Carolina here. And here you can see those spiral bands moving up from the south over southeastern North Carolina. And in this band right here, right along the beaches of southeastern North Carolina, we've had reports of some winds to hurricane force. And this zone right here looks like this is pretty much where the hurricane force winds are now. And it's all moving up from the south. We do have a series of interviews for you coming in from these three locations on the coast in North Carolina. We'll have them for you in just a moment. Here are the particular story from the Hurricane Center as of tomorrow. Jeff, you've been there all morning. We've been watching the weather and what's been happening here the past half hour or so.
Well, it's quieted down a little bit, Mark, from the last time I talked to you. We had a pretty heavy squall move through. It had, believe it or not, some hailstones, as I mentioned. Very small, they didn't last very long, and a brief real blast of wind and rain. And that's gone, and that's pretty much the nature of it so far. Looks like we have another fairly good squall coming in offshore, probably in another couple of minutes, give us another little dose of rain. We can pan up the beach here and see what we're looking at, and you can kind of get the feel of, you know, what the Outer Banks are kind of like here. You get the ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, and then you have a very thin barrier sand dune there protecting the rest of the structures behind it or Highway 12. And you can kind of get a sense of why we always talk about Highway 12 getting overwashed a lot, because it doesn't take much for this dune line to get breached when the Atlantic Ocean gets angry in cases like this. And at times it can kind of isolate the island even more. You can wash over and you can't get in or out. Let's hope it doesn't happen this time, but it is possible. We have heard of some overwash down on Ocracoke Island and a little bit on the south end of Hatteras Island a little bit earlier today, but that was particularly at high tide. Right now we're pretty much getting in toward low tide, but later on this afternoon we may have to deal with that again.
Okay, thank you, Jeff, and I notice it looks like it's getting kind of dark there as we can see the shadows from the lights that are on you, and weather is about to get a little crazy there in a short time, so we'll check on you in about another half hour.
Okay.
Hey, thanks a lot, Jeff. And let's take you down the coast just a little bit. I'm coordinator of Carteret County. And Al, what's it doing outside right now?
Well, right now it's just started to rain again. We've probably got 15, 20 knots of wind, and it's just started to rain again. Looks like it's going to be raining probably for the next hour here.
Do you have any reports on what's happening at the beaches?
We're getting some surf, getting some wind, and I think everything is, you know, pretty well buttoned down. People seem to be doing fine. Haven't had any complaints from the beaches. I think things are, you know, people are ready to ride it out.
Okay, thank you very much. And we'll be reporting to us via phone. And so at Curray Beach, which is just outside of Wilmington, New Hanover County, I do believe things have been getting kind of wild there, Vin, haven't they?
Hey, Mark, I'll tell you what, it's pretty nasty here. We're starting to feel the full effects of Bertha here. Sustained winds going to be up around 60 miles an hour with some gusts over hurricane force. Seas have been building anywhere up around 10 feet, occasionally up around 20 feet coming in over a pier. The Curray Beach pier is about, say, 18 feet above the ocean surface, and the waves are cresting out to the top of that pier. So for here, we're watching telephone poles very cautiously. A lot of transformers are on the verge of coming down, and also street lights blowing around vigorously this morning.
Okay, you mentioned you're watching the power lines, et cetera. Have you seen any damage so far?
A lot of shingles coming off the roofs of buildings, and the State Patrol, very, very cautious through here. You can't go up and down this island at all. The mandatory evacuation, of course, in effect yesterday, and they are frequently coming by. State troopers of North Carolina keeping all spectators off the roads. They've come by to us and made sure that we stayed right in our hotel parking lot. So we're expecting that storm surge to come up through here and give us a few, maybe some water in the parking lot.
Okay, thank you very much, Vinny, and we'll be talking to you in just a little while as the storm is headed right in your direction. Let's take a look now at that orange area. That shows us where some of the more enhanced cloud tops are. Now we close right into Cape Fear right here. Here's Wilmington, and here comes our storm swirling up from the south center of circulation right through here, and that is headed right up towards Wilmington. So as we go to the radar, real close review here, you see the center of the storm here, and here comes that band with the hurricane force wind. So this is where it's really bad now, just coming into extreme southeastern North Carolina. Other bands of heavier rain moving up as well. So here it comes, Hurricane Bertha, and it looks like the southeastern North Carolina will be feeling the worst of it.
Stationary front, which reaches across the south central portion of the United States, there is an area where rain has been occurring this morning, and a flash flood watch is in effect for southeast Oklahoma and west central Arkansas through tonight. Abundant moisture and an unstable atmosphere have resulted in the development of widespread showers and thunderstorms across southeast Oklahoma this morning. Rainfall rates of 1 to 2 inches per hour will be possible as the showers and thunderstorms drift very slowly across the area. Here's a look at the record lows that have been reported this morning. Denver, 73 degrees.
Well, early this afternoon and after.